Good evening. I am Dr. Faizal M Iqbal, consultant senior orthopedic surgeon of Kottakkal Aster MIMS. I am here to give you a small demonstration about a very new and innovative spinal surgical procedure called percutaneous endoscopic lumbar discectomy. Each word has its meaning. It's percutaneous means it's through the skin, endoscopic by using an endoscope. Lumbar, we utilize the lumbar spine for major procedures, and it's a discectomy. So it's a percutaneous transforaminal endoscopic lumbar discectomy. You utilize the normal God-given foramens of the spine to get into the disc and get the disc diseases cured. Unlike the open surgeries which we utilize by either microscope or the conventional open surgeries which we call the laminectomy discectomy, we are not violating any normal God-given structures like the bone, the fascia, the supraspinous ligaments or whatever it is which we normally use for the open surgeries to go inside the spine to retract the spinal cord and get into the disc space, which is absolutely not being employed in this new or innovative technique. We utilize the normal foramen, indubitable foramen, which we use to go inside by way of guide wires and various automated computerized techniques. We get into the disc, we utilize the scope to view the disc pathologies and remove the whatever pathologies are there. The most common being disc prolapse. You know, 80% of the low back aches account from disc prolapses. Few come from canal stenosis, few come from infective pathologies like tubercular spine, infective discitis, which we all can employ this newer technique to get the disease cleared. And you can even use this technique for utilizing biopsies from the disc, from in and around the bone. So though it's not a panacea, it's a really a innovative technique where the disc diseases can be tackled by a simple local anesthetic procedure. We utilize our anesthetic friends to give a monitored anesthesia care. We give small sedatives, but the patient is lie awake. Patient is as awake as he is normally doing his activities. The only thing is, he is just out of the tension zone. If I give small sedatives, patient is out of the tension and phobias of getting into the OT. So the patient is awake, he is responding to our commands, he is giving us all the feedbacks what we need during the surgery. So we give a small local anesthesia into the skin, get into the disc by way of needles, guide wires, cannulas. So once we are in the disc, we confirm that we are dealing with the right disc as confirmed by the MRI or previous examination. We confirm that we are in the disc by giving a small injection called the DICE, radio-opaque DICE. We confirm that we are in the disc. We confirm the position. Then we start off with the surgery by introducing the scope. So the procedure may last from somewhere around 45 minutes to 1.5 hours, depending upon what level we are dealing, what pathology we are dealing. And here is one of our patients just after the surgery, and he is lying down quite awake. The surgery is just over. He came to us with L4, L5 disc prolapse, and he had a chronic long-standing disease, but for the last 6 months, he was having excruciating pain down the leg. He is a police officer, but he was not able to do his daily routine activities. So we have taken up for this procedure, and as doubted from the MRI, he had a calcified disc, which was a little difficult to remove. So as opposed to the normal disc, his disc covering called the annulus was covered by calcium deposit. This was a calcified annulus. So we took a bit of more of a time and curating out the annulus, and we could finally get the nerve roots decompressed, and on table we could get the feedback from the patient that his leg is pain has decreased, and we made him cough. It's called the Valsalva maneuver, and the pain was not radiating anymore down the leg. So that was the end point of the surgery, and the patient, we hope that the patient will be doing extremely fine. And thank you for watching this video. Please get back to us for details. Thank you.